Alright guys, we've got a 2007 Big Dog K-9 Softail Chopper motorcycle for sale. This bike currently has 3,813 very well cared for miles. Now this particular bike is equipped with the Candy Apple Metallic Green base paint job. And you have silver tribal accents. Definitely a very, very gorgeous paint job. Now in 2007, Big Dog equipped these bikes with the extremely powerful 1,916cc, 117 cubic inch S&S V-twin motor. They also equipped the bikes with the 6-speed Baker transmission. You have a right side balance drive. You have PM disc brakes. And also PM polished billet wheels. They definitely didn't spare any expenses when they built this bike. Up front you've got a 21 inch rim. In the rear you've got an 18 inch rim with a gigantic 300 millimeter tire. Definitely gives the bike that classic chopper look. Now the bike does have some additions. First off, I'll start off with the sissy bar ready struts. What this will allow you to do is to pop in a sissy bar right in those holes, and it will allow you to add the sissy bar, or you can add a backrest pad or a storage rack to facilitate some gear. The bike is also equipped with a rear passenger pegs, again that will allow you to add a pillion pad or two-up seat, which will then allow you to bring a passenger. You've got the Vance and Hines big radius pipes. Definitely give the bike a great look aesthetically and sound even better. You've also got the spike grip and peg set from Big Dog. It is a BDM part. Definitely a nice addition. There's also been a spike upgrade kit just back here and also up on the triple trees. And then you've also got the Dakota digital speedometer that will replace obviously the problematic autometer factory speedometer from Big Dog. They looked okay, but if you got any moisture in them, they would definitely crap out on you, kind of thing. So now I'd rate the bike at a 9.0 out of a 10. The bike is a low mileage example, but it does have some wear and tear from being 10 years old. First off, let's go ahead and do some close-ups. You've got that rear tire. I'd say it has approximately 40% of tread remaining. So you should definitely get some life out of that. Rear fender's in pretty good shape. There are a couple of suction cup marks right there and also right there from having a two-up seat or a pillion pad on there at one time and point. Pretty common. Some of this may buff out. I haven't gotten the buffer wheel out yet, but I want to point out as much as possible. The polished billet is in pretty decent shape, but it could use some elbow grease to look perfect. It's one of those labor of love situations where you have to keep up on it to make it look like new, but it definitely hasn't been let go. The Vance & Hines exhaust is in pretty decent shape. You do have some scrapes up underneath right there on the lower heat shield. Pretty common to happen while turning the bikes, just from leaning into a turn. Looks like it's happened up on the front portion as well, right there. I just want to point out as much as I possibly can. Another blemish is a little bit in the chrome on these rear passenger peg mounts. There's a little bit of pitting on the chrome. Nothing crazy, but enough to want to point out. You've also got some oxidation on some of these bolts. And what's happened, this bike came from Texas, I'm sure from being on the coast, you've got a little bit of seawater that's caused this. Nothing crazy, but again, want to point out as much as I can. So, electrical cover's in pretty good shape, no notable blemishes there. Seat is in great condition. Gas tank's in good shape. You've got some light minor surface scratches. Almost looks like something may have dragged down a little bit. Nothing penetrating the clear coat, but just something I wanted to point out. Could be from dusting the bike off as well and having a little bit of dust underneath your cloth. Handlebars are in great shape. Mirrors are in great shape. No major blemishes there. Rocker box covers are in pretty good shape. No major blemishes there. You've got a little bit of oxidation on the rocker box bolts. Probably from getting a little bit of moisture on the bike and not wiping it off immediately. Forward foot controls are in pretty decent shape. Again, the polished billet could use a bit of polishing to look better. Front of the frame's in pretty good shape, no major blemishes. Maybe a few light bug splats on there. Headlights in good condition. No major blemishes there. In front of the triple trees, you've got some light blemishes down the post here. I'd say there's probably about 9 to 10 little spots there. Hopefully you can see that in the video. I don't know what's caused this. But again, just want to point out as much as possible. Front fender's in pretty good shape. You do have some scrapes down here on the edge of the fender. I'm assuming a rock is flipped up while driving and caused that. Not bad, but definitely want to point it out. You could always have these things repaired as well for not too much. Polished belt's in pretty good shape as well on the front wheel. Again, it could use some elbow grease to look absolutely perfect, but it should clean up really, really nice. Front fork brace is in good condition, no major blemishes there. Front tire, I'd say, has approximately 40% of tread remaining as well. So you'll definitely get some life out of that. Wheel on this side's in pretty good shape. Again, I could use some elbow grease to look perfect. The brake rotor looks like it has a little bit of blemishing from that salt water from the coast. Nothing crazy, but enough to point out and then let you know about it, kind of thing. Front forward foot control on the side's in good shape. Pegs are in good shape. Again, could use a tiny bit of elbow grease to look perfect. Polished motor's in pretty good condition. A little bit of oxidation on the engine fins here. Primary cover is in pretty decent shape. Looks like there's a bit of a blemish down here, a chip in the chrome. Electrical cover's in good condition. Again, you've got some pitting on that rear passenger peg mount. This could be replaced really, really easily. Kickstand's in pretty good shape. You've got a little bit of blemishing on the chrome as well. A little bit of rust marks inside of the head of the screw or bolt. Same thing here on the sissy bar strut. Polished wheel on the side is a good condition. Again, could use a little bit more elbow grease to look absolutely perfect. You've got the same scenario on that brake rotor as you do on the front. A little bit of blemishing, maybe some light pits, but nothing crazy. All right, let's go ahead and fire the bike up for you. right, so there you have it. Definitely shows the bike runs extremely well. Drives even better. If you have any questions, definitely don't hesitate to give me a phone call or shoot me an email. My phone number is 801-564-0629. Another great way to track our inventory is to subscribe to us on YouTube. You can also check out our direct website at www.utahchopper.com. Definitely appreciate your time, and also look forward to the possibility of working with you. Thank you so much.